Hi, I'm Mitchell Anikas, a technical writer at DigitalOcean. In this screencast, I'll show you how to secure Nginx with a free SSL certificate from Let's Encrypt. Let's Encrypt is a new certificate authority that provides an easy way to obtain and install free TLS SSL certificates. These certificates can be used with any web server software, such as Nginx, Apache, or HAProxy, to provide encryption and authentication between your server and its users. Here's what you need before getting started. Root or superuser access to an Ubuntu 14.04 server. If you don't have one, follow this link to create one on DigitalOcean. You will also need a registered domain, such as example.com, and the ability to change name server records. To complete our setup, we will follow these steps. First, we'll point our domain name to our server. Then, on the server, we'll install Nginx and the Let's Encrypt client. After obtaining the SSL certificate, we will configure Nginx to use it. Lastly, we will set up a script that will automatically renew our SSL certificate before it expires. If you already have completed the first two steps and have an Nginx server that is accessible via a domain name, just skip them. Let's get started. To point your domain to your server, go to the control panel for your domain's name servers so you can make sure that you have the proper A records in place. This will allow your users to access your server by going to your domain name in a web browser. Also, Let's Encrypt will only issue a certificate to a server that is accessible via domain name. I'll show you how to do this using DigitalOcean's DNS. If you're using some other DNS service, the process should be more or less the same. If your domain doesn't already exist in the system, create it. I'm using mitchellanikas.com. Then create an A record for the domain name and another for the www version of the domain. Both of them point to my server's public IP address. Once the DNS information propagates, you should be able to access your server via your domain name. Now we're ready to install Nginx, the web server software. First, log into your Ubuntu server using SSH. The command to do this is SSH, followed by your username, the @ symbol, and your domain name. Once you're logged in, update your apt-get repository listings with sudo apt-get update. Then install Nginx with sudo apt-get install Nginx. Enter yes at the prompt. Once the installation is complete, Nginx will be running with the default page. You can verify this by visiting your domain over HTTP in a web browser. Currently, the best way to install the Let's Encrypt client is to simply clone it from the official GitHub repository. In the future, it will likely be available via a package manager, such as apt-get. So let's install Git. Type in sudo apt-get install Git. Now we can use this git command to clone Let's Encrypt to our server's opt directory. Now, with Let's Encrypt installed, we can obtain free SSL certificates. Let's Encrypt provides a few different mechanisms or plugins that it can use to authenticate that your server should be issued an SSL certificate. The most simple authenticator is the standalone plugin, which works by temporarily running a basic web server on port 80 so that Let's Encrypt can verify that your domain belongs to your server. Because the standalone authenticator listens on port 80, the standard port for HTTP traffic, we need to stop Nginx temporarily with sudo service nginx stop. Now change to the Let's Encrypt directory with cd /opt/letsencrypt. Use the standalone plugin by running this command. At the prompt, enter your email address. Then agree to the Let's Encrypt subscriber agreement. Then enter your domain names. I want my certificate to work with the www and non-www versions of my domain, so I'll enter both of them here. If everything goes well, you will see output that looks like this. The output should show you the location of your certificate files and the expiration date of your certificate. You can verify that all of the relevant files have been created with this command. We will be using the full chain.pem and privkey.pem files with Nginx. Now we'll configure Nginx to use the Let's Encrypt certificate, which will enable encrypted HTTPS traffic. We will also configure plain HTTP connections to be redirected to HTTPS. I'm going to use the Vim editor to edit the default Nginx server block configuration with sudo vim /etc/nginx/sites-enabled/default. If you're not familiar with Vim, I would recommend using the nano editor instead. Find the server block. Comment out or delete the lines that configure the server to listen on port 80. Next, in the server block, add listen443ssl:. This configures Nginx to listen on port 443 for SSL connections. Then specify your server name like this, server_name, and then your domain names. Of course, you will want to use your own domain name here. Then we have to specify the SSL certificate and private key, like this. When you're done, it should look like this. Now we will add a few lines to the server block so that Nginx will only use the most secure SSL protocols and ciphers. Lastly, outside of the original server block, we'll create a server block that will listen on port 80 and redirect the traffic to the HTTPS server block we just configured. It should look like this. Now, save and exit the file. If you want to see the completed example configuration file, check out the link in the annotations. To put the changes into effect, restart Nginx with sudo service nginx restart. The Let's Encrypt TLS SSL certificate is now in place. At this point, you should test that the SSL certificate works by visiting your domain in a web browser. You can verify that the Let's Encrypt certificate is being used by clicking on the lock icon in the address bar. Let's Encrypt certificates are valid for only 90 days. To avoid having to remember to manually renew our certificates every 3 months, we can automate the renewal process. I'll show you how to set up a certificate auto-renewal now. We'll be leveraging the Let's Encrypt Webroot Authenticator. The Webroot plugin allows us to use Nginx to serve a special file that the Let's Encrypt CA can read to verify that your server should be issued a new or renewed certificate. Open your Nginx configuration again. Under the SSL server block, add this location block. You will also want to look up what your document root is set to by searching for the root directive, as the path is required to use the Webroot plugin. If you're using the default configuration file, the root will be /user/share/nginx/html. Save and exit. Next, we need to create a Let's Encrypt configuration file. This will allow us to use Let's Encrypt to request an SSL certificate without user interaction, which is necessary to set up a fully automated renewal process. Copy the example Let's Encrypt configuration file to /user/local/etc with this command. Now open the file in an editor. Uncomment the email line and fill in your email address. Then uncomment the domains line and enter your domain names. Be sure to put these in the same order that you used when you requested the certificate the first time. Then uncomment the webroot path line and update it to match your Nginx document root. My server is using the default root path, so I don't need to update it. Your file should look something like this. Save and exit when you're ready to move on. Now we can use the configuration file with Let's Encrypt to request a certificate. Assuming your configuration file is correct, these commands can be used to renew your certificate. To automate the renewal process, we will use a shell script that will verify the certificate expiration date for the provided domain and request a renewal when the expiration is less than 30 days away. This script will be scheduled to run once a week as a cron job. This way, even if the renewal request fails, there's a 30-day window to try again every week. First, download the script to /user/local/sbin with this curl command. Feel free to review the contents of the script before running it. Make it executable with this command. The lrenew webroot script takes an argument, the domain name whose certificate you want to check for renewal. When the renewal is not yet necessary, it will simply output how many days are left until the given certificate will expire. For example, if you run the script now, you will be able to see how many days are left before your certificate will expire. Now that our renewal script is in place, all we need to do is schedule a cron job that will run the script once a week. Open your server's root cron tab with sudo crontab-e. Then add this line to execute the script every Monday at 2:30 a.m. The output produced by this command will be sent to a log file located at /var/log/lerenewal.log. That's it! Your web server is now using a free Let's Encrypt TLS SSL certificate to securely serve HTTPS content.
We hope you enjoyed the screencast. If you're looking to learn more about open source software and server administration, be sure to check out the DigitalOcean community for our extensive collection of tutorials at do.co/community. See you next time!